Guys, so today I wanted to talk about some of my eyeshadow palette deal breakers. These are things that are kind of pet peeves to me, and whenever I see a new palette that has one or more of these characteristics, I'm probably not going to buy it, and these are some things that help me decide when to pass on a palette. So I've got five main deal breakers to share. Eyeshadow palettes are one of my favorite things to collect. I don't view every like category of makeup as something that I enjoy collecting, but eyeshadow palettes really do bring me a lot of joy. You know, I'm kind of always on the hunt for that next new palette to bring into my collection. But like with all of my makeup, I like to keep my eyeshadow palette collection pretty, not necessarily minimal, but curated to the point where I know I can use everything, rotate through everything, and none of it is gonna just sit in my drawer and collect dust. So these are some things that help me decide when to maybe skip out on a palette. So number one is when a palette has too many overlapping shades. The brand that really comes to mind that I think is the biggest offender here is Morphe. They are notorious for those big palettes. What are they, like 32 shade palettes? And there will be, you know, so many different shades of brown and taupe that all basically look the same. And there's other brands that do this too. It's like, in my mind, if I'm paying for, you know, 12, 15, 20 shades in a palette, to me that just feels like such wasted space, and it just feels to me like the brand didn't put very much thought or intention into the shades that they chose for the palette. So that's one really big pet peeve of mine. And then one that kind of goes hand in hand with that is when a palette is just too big. When there's too many shades in a palette, I'm probably not going to feel inspired to use it. For me, it's typically like 15 to 18 shades is my limit. The largest palettes that I have, I think, are 18 shades, like the e.l.f. Earth and Ocean palette. I love that one. And with that palette in particular, each shade is different enough from the rest of the shades in the palette that it feels like, you know, a good use of 18 shades. But when you're getting into 20, 25, 30 pan palettes, or, you know, there's like 80 pan palettes out there, they're too overwhelming for me. I don't even know where to start. And also, if the palette is too big, it's gonna be harder for me to store. And this goes for any makeup product. If I'm not able to store it in my drawers, then it's just not practical for me. Another pet peeve and deal breaker for me is pressed glitters. I do have two palettes in my collection that contain a pressed glitter, and I never use those shades. They're not technically eye safe, so I just don't feel comfortable putting those around my eyes. You only have two eyes, and I feel like I want to take care of my eyes as best I can because I'd like to keep them. So pressed glitters, the ones that I do have, I want to eventually figure out other ways to use them. Like I know you can potentially use them as like nail polish toppers and things like that, so I'm going to try that so that they're not completely going to waste. Another thing that's kind of a deal breaker for me with palettes is when either a palette doesn't have enough shimmers in it, or if the shimmers are not interesting, then I'm probably going to skip out on a palette. I'm mainly purchasing palettes for the shimmers, and then the mattes are just in there to complement those shimmers. Occasionally I'll do an all matte look, very rarely, but almost every single day I'm wearing some kind of shimmer on my lid. The shimmers are like the main event for me when it comes to palettes. And when I see a palette, especially like a new palette come out on the market, and it only seems to have very basic shimmers that don't have much of a shift to them or don't have much dimension to them, I know I already have my basic like golds and creams and taupey shimmers in my collection, and I only need so many of those. I really like to see palettes that have, you know, maybe some duochromes in them, or just some shimmers that seem to have a lot of dimension to them, even if they're not like full-on duochrome, because then I know it's really going to add to my collection. And then of course the mattes are important too. I need them to be pigmented and blendable and all of those things, but I'm not as concerned about the mattes because mattes are mattes. They're not going to be like super dimensional, but they just need to be there to anchor those shimmers. And, you know, if a palette only has like one or two shimmers in it or no shimmers, I'm probably not gonna purchase it. The last big deal breaker for me is when a palette is arranged in a way that doesn't make sense or isn't intuitive and that I feel like distracts from the palette itself. So one palette that comes to mind, and this actually isn't even the way that the pans are arranged so much as the way that they're presented. The Juvia's Place Wahala 2 palette. Now, don't get me wrong, a lot of the Juvia's Place palettes look really beautiful, and I've heard amazing things about their formula, so this isn't a knock on Juvia's Place whatsoever, but the palette, the background is so colorful, and I feel like it just distracts me from the shades themselves, and I just can't even figure out what's going on with these shades. But now, actually looking at these shades, this is another prime example of a palette that has too many overlapping shades. There's three columns of blue here, and let's see, one, two, three, four of these like royal blue shimmers look exactly the same. Two of the matte blues look almost the same, one's just a little deeper than the other, but those big like swirling stripes of color don't even really go that well with the colors in the palette, and I just can't even figure out what's going on. It's too overwhelming to look at, and typically I prefer when palettes just have, you know, your basic square or circle pans that are just laid out in a row and the layout is intuitive. You know, here's another example, this BH Cosmetics palette. I feel like the layout just makes sense. It's not overwhelming. It's easy for me to look at this and come up with a good look. When a brand tries to really like think outside the box and do something creative with the arrangement of the pans, it usually just doesn't work out. One example are these Too Faced limited edition palettes that I think they came out with over the holidays last year. They're like 8 pan palettes. They're, you know, pretty small and compact. And 6 of the shades are just normal square pans, and then on the left side, they've got these like slightly shorter rectangles. I don't know why they didn't just make those square pans, because it looks like the same amount of product as the other shades, but it just completely throws off the balance of the palette, and it just annoys me to look at. Or when the shades are all like different size pans and scattered around in a weird way, that's annoying. I don't always mind when some of the shades are larger than the others, but it still overall looks like a nice, well-balanced palette that makes sense. That's fine. Like an example of a palette that is laid out differently, but I actually really like, is the Aether, really any of these Aether palettes. This is the Rose Quartz palette, but all of their palettes are kind of laid out this way, where, you know, there's these four middle shades that are kind of like these little diamonds, and then they've got these kind of larger triangle pans surrounding those. To me, this is still, it's nice and symmetrical, and the way that it's laid out makes sense because the four middle shades are all kind of a different texture of shadow. Those are kind of like your duochromes. And then you've got your mattes and like your more basic shimmers around the edges. I know some people don't really like this like different layout that Aether does, but I actually really like it. It makes sense in my brain, so I don't mind it. But so it doesn't necessarily have to be the most basic standard layout for me to like it, but it's when the layout or the packaging or the background of the palette distracts from the colors themselves and the color story, that's when it's a no for me. So those are my main 5 palette deal breakers. When I avoid palettes that have those problems, those little pet peeves of mine, it does help me make sure that I'm only bringing in palettes that I'm actually going to enjoy using and having in my collection. So I would love to hear what your palette deal breakers are in the comments, but otherwise I'd love to have you subscribe to my channel if you've not already. I upload typically 3 videos a week, so I'd love to see you again very soon, and hopefully I'll talk to you in my next video. Bye!